Across the pond, the countdown to the royal wedding, which is just 3 months and 8 days away, in case you're wondering. And tonight we're getting some new details about it. Let's get straight to our royal correspondent, Max Foster, who is in London for us. Hi, Max.
Hi, Anna. Yeah, we're getting a better sense of the shape of the day. So we now know that the service will start at noon at St. George's Chapel in Windsor Castle, UK time. So 7 o'clock Eastern. So it'll be a morning for the Eastern United States. It'll be a morning event. You can see there the route they're going to take, and they're going to travel up the long walk. So this is what's going to happen after the service at 1 o'clock. They're going to take a carriage procession out of the castle. They wanted to meet as many people as possible, wanted to share the day with as many people as possible. But obviously the actual castle's in lockdown, so they wanted to go out in a carriage procession. So it's going to be a bit of a more grand affair than we expected. We can take you inside the chapel as well. These are new images that were taken on behalf of the broadcasters within the chapel, and you get a real sense of how beautiful this scene is. It's about half the size of Westminster Abbey, which is where Prince William and Kate Middleton got married, but it's much more intimate space and it'll be very beautiful. So we're getting a sense of the day. We also know that the Archbishop of Canterbury, who's the most senior official in the Church of England, will be overseeing the vows. Now, it's not a state occasion, but it is a very important national occasion. That's really emphasizing that as well.
How fun. What about the reception? Any word on details or where that will be?
Only that they're going to be coming back from the carriage procession to a reception within St. George's Hall, another really picturesque room within the castle, usually used for state banquets. So they're going to join the congregation there. And then later on in the evening, Prince Charles is going to have a more intimate affair. We don't know where that's going to be. It's going to be very private. But they're trying to share some of the day and keep some of it private. Prince Harry's very careful about how he opens up his life. He's quite controlled, and we're getting a sense of that, and the way they're dripping information to us as well is part of that as well. But they do want the world to be involved, and certainly they'll all be able to see it live, because it's going to be evening in Asia, it's going to be morning in North America, and lunchtime in Europe. So it's going to be quite well watched, I think.
Oh gosh, I remember the big wedding with Kate and Prince William. Thank you so much, Max Foster, for the update there.